Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1601 of our daily Naseehah and advice. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Yesterday we concluded 1600 of the Naseehah with the help and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. We must place on record our sincerest thanks to our brother Maulana Ahmad Dokrat Hafidhullah. May Almighty Allah reward him, his family, his parents, his children, mashallah, and Almighty Allah accept it from all of us. When we turn the pages of history, then we see on the 6th of Ramadan, 532, corresponding to the 24th of May, 1138, Gregorian calendar, the first victory was granted to the Muslims against the Christian crusaders in Halab. Halab is known as Aleppo in Syria. The leader of the Muslims at that time was Imaduddin Zanki, rahimahullah. There are three people whose names, these personalities' names, will shine when we speak about the victory of the Muslims against the crusaders. Salahuddin Ayyubi, rahimahullah, Saladin the Just, Imaduddin Zanki, rahimahullah, and Nuruddin Zanki, rahimahullah. May Almighty Allah grant each one of them and the Mujahideen the highest stages in Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la. When we study our sunnahs today, let us focus on salat. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man thabara ala thintay asharat rakatan, banallahu lahu biha baytan fil jannah. Whosoever reads these 12 rakats daily and is punctual and regularly, Almighty Allah Jalla wala will bless him with a palace in Jannah, the hadith in Musnad Ahmad, various compilations. So which are the 12 rakats we speak about, the sunnat muakkada? 2 rakats are before the Fajr Salat, so that is sunnat muakkada. Then 4 rakats, remember, before the Zuhr Salat, so that is sunnat muakkada. And after the Zuhr Salat, we have 2 rakats also to read them. And then after Maghrib, we have 2 rakats. And then after Isha, we have the 2 rakats. So that is how you reach the 12. So 2 before Fajr, 4 before Zuhr, 2 after Zuhr, and 2 after Maghrib, 2 after Isha. And that is the 12 Sunnati Muakkada. Many a time people undermine the importance of these salats. Remember, that is unacceptable and sinful unless a person is a musafir, a traveler, and so forth and so on. And our dua for today, we are in the month of Ramadan Mubarak, and it is mentioned Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahaba used to read the following dua. Allahumma, this is after iftar or iftar time. Allahumma inni as'aluka. You can read before iftar, after iftar, all acceptable, it's flexible. Allahumma inni as'aluka. Oh beloved Allah, I beg of thee. Bi rahmatika allati, through your mercy. Wasiyat kulla shay, that encompasses everything. An taghfira li, that you forgive me. And we're making collective dua with our wives, our children and parents or siblings. So read an taghfira lana, that Ya Allah, you forgive us. The hadith is mentioned in Ibn Majah, and remember, it is also mentioned that Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhumah used to recite this dua as well. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatika allati wasi'at kulla shay an taghfira li. Say, O antaghfira lana. Remember that Almighty Allah says and mentions in the Noble Quran, Wa rahmati wasiyat kulla shay. My mercy envelopes and encompasses everything. So through the mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla wala, we are begging for forgiveness. May Almighty Allah forgive us, and may Almighty Allah accept siyamana wa qiyamana wa tilawatana wa jami'a amalina saliha. Ya Allah, all our good deeds, through your rahmah and your mercy and grace, you accept it. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.